Everyone, and welcome to Aunt Salve Women. Today for my 101, we are going to discuss my article on the search for purpose. And so some of you may consider it as a pursuit of purpose. Either way, understand that you are going through a journey of finding what your purpose is. Now, for me, it has been such an awakening to really come to a moment in my life where I asked myself, what is next? I felt like if any of you have ever gotten to a position where you have gotten to a moment where you ask yourself, what is there of me that is needed? What is there of me that must continue on to matter in this world or have some type of significance? And it was so interesting because when I arrived there, I had to then find peace. There was no way that I could keep going feeling empty, feeling as if I did not have a position. And so in my article, I have shared with you in the pursuit of purpose or the search for purpose, I really had to come up with something that would give me that peace of mind to say, okay, I may not always know what is there for me to be doing or what my role is in looking for what it is that I'm supposed to be doing or that it's not clear to me. But there's what I use as my mnemonics to always remember certain things to really get into that mindset of arriving to, okay, here is what's going to keep me at a level of just a level of stability, of, you know, my peace of mind and heart and spirit of moving forward. So the very first one, and here goes the acronym purpose. P is really understanding how to perfect all there is about you. Understand this is different from saying you are perfect. Perfect means, wow, there's nothing about you to fix. You are great. You are just doing incredible. And everything you do is at that level 10 where everyone's like, oh my gosh, it's amazing. You're incredible. And good for you if you're there. For me, I just know that there's always that room for betterment. And at least for my sake, I can look at something and reflect upon it and say, how could I have I done this better? And what could I do tomorrow or the next time that I arrive at this where it could be a lot better or more improved than it is now? And that room for growth is so important because for me, it's really understanding that it is in my errors, not that I do them intentionally. I'm not one to say, oh, if I do wrong, I'll, you know, it's okay and I'll be forgiven. I am one, and I'm sure many of you are, where you're always constantly trying to do it right. But at least I have really arrived at that development of the mind and the spirit to say, you know what? I really had the intention to be excellent, and yet I fell short. So what could I do to really arrive at doing it right next time? And so perfecting really that masterpiece of you is important. And so just remember to just perfect all there is about you, and so that you get a chance to do it again and again and again until you feel like you're getting it right. Keep that in mind. Perfect all there is about you. Does not mean you're perfect. It means that you're working towards that. And so the next one is understand you. You understand you can't always have everything feel right. I remember reading about Solomon, and he had asked about wisdom. And I was like, gosh, that's amazing, right? The story that he talked about where he was trying to determine who was the true mother of this one child. And so for me, I really thought about that. And I was like, gosh, you know, wisdom is something that I'm gaining from all those around me. So many great minds around me. I love talking to people. I'm loving to siphon whatever I can from this world. However, it is so difficult sometimes, just for me speaking, to know what is right from wrong. And you know, yeah, there are some that are so straightforward, right? We know doing drugs, bad, right? And so, you know, and being anything that is harmful is not a good thing. And so for me, it's more of the discernment though. Like, let me know if I'm going in the right direction. Let me know if this should feel right. So what I would be asking, if it were me to be asked, is discernment. Help me to know that I'm going in the right path. So for this one is understand you can't always have everything feel right. That's just, hopefully you can relate to that. It's like, gosh, am I going in the right direction? Am I supposed to be doing this? And so for me, the way I can actually say to myself, you may not always know if this is right, but just do the right thing. Be the right person. Do the righteous part. And know that if you continue in that, then that is going to be of light. And no matter what, it's at least you know that you're not putting yourself in the journey of going into the wrong. Even though you're not certain if it is right, at least you're saying to yourself, you know, I'm going to continue to just do the right thing, think the right thing, and just continue on to be around the right. And that way I can at least do my part in being on the right path. And that is how I feel I could be certain that even though I'm not certain if it feels right, that I am doing right. Next one is R, respect yourself in the process. It saddens me to think that anyone has arrived to abundance, anyone has arrived to the win, anyone has arrived to something magnificent, and yet they know deep inside they lost respect for themselves, or they did it in a disrespectful way, or they did it in a dishonorable way to get there. If you're okay with it, then you have a stronger sense of self than perhaps I do, because I know for me, it is so important for me to feel right on the inside of whatever it is I've done. And so respecting yourself is important. As you grow in life, you want to be able to look at yourself in the mirror and go, you know what? It's okay. I did it in a right way, and I may not have accomplished just what I wanted to. I may not have taken it to the level I would have wanted to, but I can still look at myself in the mirror and know that I have still to respect myself, and I can say to myself that others can still respect me. Those who are looking at me, those who are looking for an inspiration, or just thinking to have maybe done it a different way, they're looking at me and going, okay, wait, he or she is doing it in a way of honor, in a way of honesty. And so respecting yourself in the process, to me, ultimately, is really the core of it all. Is at the end of the day, you can look at yourself and be at peace, and just know that you are still that goodness that you started off with, and you didn't lose yourself to being a sellout to anything outside of that goodness. The next one, P, back to another P, is plan on doing something to move forward. It is okay to fall back. Sometimes I look back so that it reminds me of where I don't want to go. If I have to fall forward, again, going back to Denzel Washington, of stating that we fall forward, who cares that you're stumbling? But you're moving forward. You know, if you stumble, however it may be, you're a few steps forward instead of a few steps back. And so plan on doing something where there is that pursuit to go to the next day instead of being stuck of where you were yesterday. It's not a good feeling to feel as if you're in a gutter and that you haven't gotten yourself out. If you've ever been there, no one wants to stay. And if you're staying there, you have to ask yourself, have you allowed yourself to be defeated in that mind of yours or your spirit of yours, where you're all of a sudden saying to yourself that you can't get out? Because then ultimately we'll go into that piece furthermore of, what are you allowing into your mind to have convinced you that? So plan on doing something that pushes you forward to, as you're pursuing, as you're moving in to throughout your journey of pursuing or searching for your purpose, whatever you may not even know it may be, just keep planning to move forward. The next one is O, only accept positivity. This to me was a big learning lesson for me, because I wanted to, there was a time where I wanted to just really respect everybody else's perspectives and thoughts, and I didn't want them to feel as if they didn't matter. It got to a point where I felt like the negativity was starting to rain, and then it was starting to flood. And then all of a sudden, I realized, oh my goodness, I'm going to drown if I don't get out of this. There are that type of people around you. They don't know. They don't know that they're doing it, because all they have is negativity. They don't even realize it. And that's all they can feed, because they have so much darkness in them. And because out of your love and respect for them, all of a sudden they're throwing it at you. And then all they're feeding you whatever it is that is the opposite of what you need, which is positivity, which is light. And then all of a sudden, it may be too late, and then you drown in it. And so keep in mind to accept only positivity. Do your best. My favorite verse is in Ephesians 6, and I believe it's 10 to 8 through 18, where it talks about the belt of truth, the armor of righteousness, the shoes of the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, and then the sword of the spirit, which is the word of God. So for me, that has always kept me to go, okay, hold on. I had to really shield myself and be aware of what's coming toward me. And that goes with just experience in life. When you've had enough negativity coming in and you've learned from it, you've reflected from it, makes you go, not again. And you know, every day, that's just something that you have to be aware of, and you have to stand guard and be conscious of it, knowing that it can come any given time. And some of them are very sneaky. So be careful, only accept positivity. Next one is S, silence your own doubts. Whew, this one, I always feel like sometimes in this in pink, right? Don't let me get me. And for me, it's like, oh, that makes so much sense, because I am my biggest enemy at times. I am always talking my way out of things. And all of a sudden, sometimes doubts and fears are just, you know, just what I'm feeding myself is really what's holding me back. And unfortunately, what I have come to understand is I have delayed a process just because I took so long just listening to it. And just all those thoughts, you know, and I could have gotten something done like instantly, and yet it took me weeks, if not months, maybe a year, you know, honestly, because all of a sudden I just was stuck in my thought process of thinking, well, what if it doesn't come to be because you were the only one who held yourself back from getting it done? And I have now understood that if I hold myself back, there could be other people counting on me. I could be that missing jigsaw puzzle piece that is a completion of what everybody else needs to get things done collectively. And understand that. Once you understand that, sometimes it's not just you who is being effective. It could, you know, for your own self, it could be really a united front to make sure that things are getting done, and everyone in this world could be waiting on you to do that part. And if you don't do that part, then who else will? It's you're the only one that's holding it back. And you may not even know people. You may even not ever run into people. But it's that one thought in your mind. And this is, you know, when people create things, invent things, it's like you're holding the whole world back because you were the creative and great mind to really pursue it. And how many years did you hold back from getting it done? The world is waiting on you. Lastly is E, embrace the pursuit of getting there. I have gotten to this peace of mind where I say to myself when I wake up, again, talking to yourself before you even get up, you have to say to yourself, my body's not willing to do this, but my mind and my spirit has to tell my body to get up. Because you have to embrace that pursuit of getting to that search for purpose or that pursuit of purpose. You may not even know that a child is waiting on you to say the right thing and make them feel that they can keep going, that they matter, or that your children need you to just push them to that next level and make them understand that they are so much more than what they see in themselves, because the world has been bogging down on them. And sometimes you may be that tough love that makes them go, no, you know, you have everything in you to keep going and you have to stop doubting. Sometimes it's not how you feel on the inside, it's the words that come out of your mouth that feeds what others need to hear. Even if you don't believe it, those words that you throw out to people is what they need to hear to keep them moving. It's not always about you when it comes to that purpose. And then also your spouse, they may need you to really just get up. And when they see you moving, then they're moving. And so many things in this world, it's that embracing that pursuit of getting to your purpose. And not realizing that as you continue to move, there are others who are affected by your every movement, by your every word, by your every gesture, by your every smile. There's every piece of you that is someone else is counting on. And really arrive at that, understanding how important you are, that every moment, and you know, there may be a day where there, you know, you were only supposed to just be and be at peace and fill the world with warmth. And that is more than what the world could really possibly getting from someone else who is dark and gloomy. You were that light that just needed to walk around and kind of light the path for others. So just know that you really have to embrace your journey in that pursuit, because it's so important to really psych ourselves into understanding that each and every one of us matter. So I'm going to end it by hopefully thinking that I've said something to you to make you understand that the pursuit of purpose or the search for purpose is not always clear. And it's so hard. I believe it's 1 year, it was like the most searched type of Googled word or phrase of how to find purpose, right? And so that's to be understood, because a lot of us kind of have to ask ourselves, like, what's the big deal of me? Why am I not feeling it? And what I'm starting to understand, what I'm hoping to send out to you as a message today is, even if it's not clear, just know these things. Perfect all there is about you, which is the P. You understand you can't always have everything feel right. Just hope for that discernment to just know you're going that in that direction. R, respect yourself in the process. Don't lose yourself into the wrong. Don't sell yourself out. Stay straight. P, plan on doing something to move forward. Don't fall back. O, only accept positivity. Be guarded. Be guarded with what you let in. S, silence your own doubts, your own fears. Don't be defeated within your own self. You are a champion of all of your aspirations. you will get to your destiny one step at a time forward. And then E, of course, embrace the pursuit of getting there. Be at peace. Just love yourself. Keep going. In the words of my mother, God bless us all. Have another great day. If it's not going so well, guess what? Move forward. Keep going. Keep pursuing. Keep getting there. One moment at a try, I should state. And I will see you next time. Thank you for your time, everyone. Thank you.